Hello, my friends, and welcome back once again to the Chess's Obscurity. Now we are looking at a title 30 years... 30 years old by Konami. And, I was looking at another channel that actually showed this title, which I never heard of before. So we're actually going to just come right on with it with this title from 1988, brought to us by Golden Age Konami. And cheats are already simplified, so therefore, yeah. Do I need to explain why? I'm not going to play this seriously, but you know, it's for entertainment purposes only. So without further ado, he's like coin. Gangbusters! We've got an emergency! Let's move out! So, as you can tell, in this game, you capture bad guys. And as soon as you capture bad guys, you get power-ups for doing so. So the more bad guys you actually capture, the stronger your weapon becomes. So actually, I'm subscribed to a YouTuber by the name of RetroHawk. That's his channel. And like me, he actually shows games from different parts of the world. Well, not different parts of the world, but of different variety. And this is one of the games that I found interesting on this channel. So therefore, I just said, you know what, I never tried this game. And, you know, there have been times that sometimes I look up certain games just for the sake of saying I played them, and on top of that, for lore. Yeah, I've cleaned up the first area. Next area. Now, this is before other Konami games have been a thing, like Vendetta and Crime Fighters. This plays more like this actually plays more like Capcom's Avengers. Help! I think the most you can get out of this is like three of the bad guys you dispose of and capture. So a lot of early Konami games, like I said, this reminds me of Capcom's Avengers. If you never heard of that game, it really is one of those games that are basically like top-down shooters. So, I mean, this is one of the more interesting ones I've found so far. Haven't played it since I downloaded it from Emu Paradise. Second area cleaned up. Got an octopus on my head. So basically, yeah, it's basically shoot 'em up to no end, capture bad guys. I think it's about 5 or 6 levels. I don't know why, but it reminds me of Inspector Gadget if he was a cop. You know, if Inspector Gadget really was a cop before he became an inspector, I don't know. And everything turns in, and all the fish in the world becomes, well, tasty, delicious. Salmon! You know, for a cop that has like 6 rounds, you have to admit, you know, those are some powerful 6 rounds. I mean, you notice that? Has like the most powerful 6 rounds ever seen. Thank you. And all he's doing is his job to protect and serve with a mighty six shot. Sir. I missed that turn in. Kinda wish I didn't, but let's see, can I carry more than three's the maximum. Alright, where the hell's the paddy wagon? Get your tail over here. Yep, come with me. I mean, it feels like such a quick game, but it's oh so short, but it's oh so fun. Pinball man, really? Guys, come on. You're sending up pinball. Now it makes me wonder exactly where do they actually have this game located at? See, whenever I do episodes of Chess of Obscurity, it always just make me think, okay, so exactly where can you find just something like this in an arcade? I mean, I know these days, you know, arcades do not exist. Fourth area, misspelled in translation. Nope, don't you dare. My clip back. Nope. You stay with me. I need my clips. Thank you. That's the reason why I like watching other channels sometimes. Because sometimes I do watch Let's Plays. Because, you know, I'm not the only guy who usually thinks, oh yeah, I should do that game. Because if you know me for such a time, I don't do what everybody else does. But I also feel that most times, there are titles that will catch my interest and I want to share my point of view with it. Oh yeah, this totally says Contra. In that case, give me a moment, I'll be right back. And I'm back, and so is the gameplay, like so. As I said before, Contra strongly influenced a lot of the shoot 'em up genre. These look like they're refugees from guerrilla war. Believe it or not, this is like the shortest game ever known, because by the time we're actually done with it, with all this, the game will be over right about now. like so. So pretty much, yeah, that's it. And you know what this sounds like? It almost sounds like Sesame Street. The ending really does sound like Sesame Street. Dude. Do something about that chin of yours. That's just outright nasty. So really, excuse me. This was Gangbusters, brought to us by Konami. Of 1988. Stay tuned for more weird wackiness on this channel as I present another obscure title to the chest of obscurity. I've been your host, PI7, and stay tuned for more weirdness on this channel. Thank you so much for watching.